14 satellites. Awesome. Faster response time, baby. This anti-glare thing's annoying. Boy, lifting at height restriction. We're at 266 feet. All right, I'm gonna enter the park here. Get a good view of the lake. Increasing altitude to 330 feet. Whoa, I'm hitting some wind out here. Turning around. Still getting very good voltage. Alright, so I'm going to do a little sightseeing here. Thank you. Let me gain some altitude. Toggle the camera up a little bit. I think I got bit up some ants, man. Fucking mosquitoes too. Jeez. That battery sure is taking a beating. Did I step in? God damn. Unable to connect to. That's not good.
I lost contact with the
camera receiver for a second there. Man, the mosquitoes are bad here.
Where am I? Where am I? I don't see you. Oh, there you are.
Getting good voltage. We have our first low battery warning at 11 minutes. First successful landing. Hell yeah. Okay, this is just a quick tutorial about how to connect your drone to the software that is provided for the Q500 Typhoon. You need to go to the actual manufacturer's website and search up the software, download the newest software, and install it. As you can see right here in the corner, it says disconnected. You have to actually turn the drone on. It is scanning all your free ports. So I'm going to turn the drone on right now. Once the drone established connection, you'll get a status report. If you notice, the software provides you pretty much everything you need, from aligning and adjusting the motors and checking to see if they work. You notice they all say green. It basically means that the device is registering that the motors are connected. You can see right here it gives a check mark on all diagnostics, even the compass, but if you go over to calibration, it will ask that it probably be wise to adjust or recalibrate the compass. Every time you plug the device in, it'll reset the flight boundaries. I always, when I plug it in, update it all the way up. Alright, so I clicked on feet right here, and it basically put the number is set to max. It appears that the height limit for this drone, which I really doubt it'll go that high, but I'm not going to be testing the limits with it, but it says 3,281 feet. And then the range is 8,202 feet. I'm pretty sure once you lose connection with the actual receiver, it'll probably try to make its way home using the coordinates from the GPS. The software is also really good for showing you the status of it connecting to the GPS satellites. And general information, as well as the ability to do a firmware update.